Growing up at Saylorville, I've basically heard the gospel since, like, ever, since forever. So I didn't really think about it much because it was just a normal thing for me to hear about. So that was basically me when I was little. I prayed two prayers when I was little, I remember, and neither of them really changed anything except for that I thought, and I was pretty convinced too, that I was saved. I prayed them mostly because I was afraid of going to hell. And then after that, it was basically just nothing changed at all. And so some years later, I started to doubt that I was actually saved. And one summer, I remember just, I didn't know at all if I was saved anymore. So every night, I had this silly routine of coming up with the most dramatic and, like, kind of poetic, in a way, prayer that I could possibly come up with so that I could be, like, good with God and then just be more sure that I was saved, in a way, I guess. But every night I prayed, instead of being more certain, I was more and more doubtful that I was saved. Until one night, I basically just said, this is really dumb. All these fancy words and stuff, this isn't doing anything. It was just that night, instead of really thinking about what I was going to say or coming up with the big prayer that everybody kept talking about, I just poured out my heart and basically said everything on my mind to God and believed that I was a sinner and God sent his son, Jesus, to die on the cross for me, and, well, specifically to me. And I really took that to heart that night. And after that, I was really on fire for God. Like, I was reading the Bible all the time, listening, taking a lot of notes in church, and, like, telling my friends just everything. I was super excited. And then there was a time when I started to, like, just, it was kind of boring, I guess, and I stopped reading the Bible, and I stopped listening in church, and I stopped praying all the time, and so that wasn't a very good time. But then there were a couple of things that helped me to really get back in the Word and grow my relationship with Jesus, because I realized that being saved is not just that one prayer and then it's done, but you have to grow in him and spend time with him every day so that you can, like, reach others. And I went to Lake Ann, and that was super crazy and fun. And after that, I was like, okay, for real, I gotta read the Bible every day because I have to grow in the Word and in God and just in my salvation in general. So, and then also, Sarah McClintock started a Bible study with me, and that really helped me because it just gave me a kind of structure to my devotions every morning, so I wasn't just, like, flipping over the, open the Bible to a random page. I was actually reading it and learning about the verse's purposes, more understanding everything. And so ever since I've been saved, it hasn't been perfect, but I've come to realize that there are lots of trials, but with those trials, God blesses you in many ways. And so I've been anxious a lot, and one verse that really helps me is Romans 8:28, and it says, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose." And that really helps me remember that God is sovereign, and even when I don't like something that's happening in my life, I can know that that's part of his plan, and in some way that will work for good, even if I don't see it. So that's basically it, so.
Amen, amen. Jaci, that's a great testimony. I said several months ago that you don't have to have an incredible story, but you need to have a credible story, one that makes sense. And you, through the process, realized it wasn't the prayer of the child, but the person of Christ that saves you, right? Mm-hmm. And then just thanks for taking us through some of your struggles, even as a young person in Christ. That's powerful. And it's also very affirming to what the Apostle Paul said when he said, "He who began a good work in you will bring it to completion until the day of Christ Jesus, and may he continue to do that and make you a true champion for Jesus Christ." Amen? Let's have a prayer for JC. God, how thankful we are for this young woman. We pray in praise to you for saving her, for helping her to see that it wasn't an eloquent prayer, an artful prayer, or any other kind of just particular prayer other than the cry of the heart, as she said, recognizing her sin and believing in the person of Jesus who died and rose again for her. Thank you, Lord, for Jaci Shrum. Bless her so very, very much and make her a champion for you and for your glory, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Jaci, it is a great honor to baptize you upon your profession of faith and in obedience to the word of God. I do so in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.